Yeah. So we did go to Macau. It was awesome. We went bungee jumping, which is awesome. Did you ever go bungee jumping, Indian guy? Is that something you would do? It's awesome. You must do it. It'll free you. It'll be awesome. In fact, it even sounds like an Indian dish. Bungee jumping, which is like... Would you like some butter, darling? Bungee jumping. Fresh naan bread. It's naan bread? I would like the actual bread, please. But bungee jumping is awesome. You know what it is? It's because it's all about experiencing things that you are not in control of. Like, you know, sex is all about that, right? You're trying to get that thing at the end, just that uncontrollable... when you're not in control of your body, that's when it's awesome. Like when you go to the doctors and he hits your knee with a rubber tomahawk, bring, that was awesome. You go home and you try it yourself with flashlights, bong, bong, bong. It's not working, I need a rubber tomahawk. We're looking for the escape. That's what it's all about. So bungee jumping is that. It is, and any guy, what's your name? Of course. Raju. Did you ever just about done peeing in the bathroom and just right at the end you get one of these things? You ever do that? Don't lie, Raju, because all do it's a guy. No, don't bitch because I like it. I don't know what it is, but sometimes I drink 3 or 4 gallons of water looking for that one. I don't know if women get that. Ma'am, you ever get just sitting on the porcelain? Just, no. It's probably why women go in pairs to the bathroom. They're like, Becky, hold me down. I forgot my helmet. That's another awesome thing you can do. I went skydiving, which is brilliant. I don't know if you guys have ever gone skydiving. Raju, skydiving? Oh, you have a desire for that? No. It's brilliant. Anyone ever gone skydiving? Yeah? Where'd you go? If you say the sky, I'll kick you in the shin. Where'd you go? North Shore, Oahu? Oh, that's where I went. Oh, you're from Hawaii. Oh, it is brilliant. Did you go solo or tandem?
Tandem.
Oh, I know it sucks. Listen, if you're gonna go skydiving, take lessons, all right? If you don't have lessons, you gotta do a tandem jump, what we did. And I'll explain it, I'll break it down. In regular skydiving, you get a parachute. In tandem skydiving, you get a dude with a parachute. Which is bullshit. Because if bad stuff starts happening, guess what load he's cutting loose? Oh no, oh no, we're in danger. Bye-bye, Paul. And he clicks onto your back, his chest clicks on right into your back. My dive partner was this big dope-smoking Jerry Garcia biker-looking motherfucker named Long John. Which doesn't sound like anything I want strapped to my ass. And he was your height, he was like 6'4", 6'5", which meant that when we clicked together, he had to walk around like this, all bent over. Oh, great. He hooked me up with another midget again. Oh, what does this happen? And you could tell he was very angry about it, because from time to time he'd just stand right up and then throw his jacket over me. And I'd have to reappear like Quato from Total Recall.
Mars is free.
Here's something we found out, we'll share with you, is that you have to push the plane out onto the runway. I thought we'd be in a 737 with cigars and brandy. No, it's a little tiny Buddy Holly can of death that you have to push out. And I'm pushing the wing and Long John is pushing me. I'm like, get out of there, what are you doing? Why do we have to be connected now? Is that La Bamba? That's horrible choice of pre-flight music. So you push it, and the plane takes off, and it's a little tiny plane, so you're sitting single file. There's 4 other people, 2 dive couples in front of me, so I've got 4 people's weight pushing me down onto Long John. Dude, that better be your cell phone. So we take, and it's like half an hour later, we get to the drop height, 12,000 feet. Now, here's the thing they don't tell you, but I'll tell you because I'm your friend. At 8,500 feet, the atmospheric pressure drops really low. So air that's trapped in pockets of high pressure moves to the low pressure areas. Now, for all of you who failed physics, everybody farts. And it's coming back like a big Al-Qaeda anthrax cloud of doom. Just and you can't hear that because of the propellers, but you see people doing one of these little leany things. I'm just glad Long John's on the receiving end of this one. I'm like, you take it, take it, take it. Now it's time for people to jump out. The first dive couple, nice and easy. Hooray! That was awesome. Oh, the next couple, red to the window and just, that was awesome. Now it's me and Long John's turn. And I'm out the window. I got my foot on the wheel strut waiting for him to jump out with me. But no, he lets me whip around in the wind for like 5 minutes. I guess he's getting me back for giving him scoliosis on the ground. Then finally he whispers in my ear, hey, watch this. And he goes into a spin and all I see is the plane, the sky, the earth, the sky, the plane, the sky, intercut with scenes of my life. Like, wow, I shouldn't have done that and that. I guess I masturbated a lot. What the? And they pulled the ripcord. Now, here's my last bit of advice on this. Just for the guys, really. There are two straps on your skydiving gear that you should be very aware of. One that goes this way, and the other that goes this way. Make sure you have your shit sorted before they pull the ripcord. I don't have balls anymore. But the good news is I finally have coasters.